The digital signature is a quite important functionality which gives us the possibility for virtually signing documents, and we have sure that the person that has signed this document is a certain individual. For that, we need to have one public key infrastructure. It means the users that are involved in the process has to have a private key and a public key. In this process, the private key is utilized for signing the message, and the public key is utilized to verify if the signature is valid or not. So in this video, we are going to see one example of the usage of DSA algorithm, the digital signature algorithm, which we are going to execute this process of make a sign in a message and to validate this signature using the Java programming language. So what we need here? Basically, we need a possibility for, we have a specific user we are going to create, and each user has to be related to a public and a private key. And we use this native Java class, the key pair generator, to instantiate a key pair for the DSA algorithm. So we have two keys related to the user. Once the key are generated, we have two methods. One method which we are going to sync a specific message, so here's the message, and we have to inform the private key of the user that's going to sign this message, and this return the signature is related, so the message stays as it's originally generated, and we have the signature separated in a byte array. So here is the output of signature implemented in a very simple way using this native Java class, the signature. So we get the instance of DSA algorithm, use the initSigned method, passing as parameter the private key, after call the update method, passing as parameter the bytes to be signed, so here our message, and then finally we call the signed method that will generate the signature. If everything is correct, here we are going to have as the output the signature as a byte array. So the signature is there. And in another use case of your system, we have to validate if this signature is valid or not. For this purpose, we need then not more the private key, but the public key. So here in our test code, our test algorithm, we have signed a specific message based in the private key of one specific user. And now we get the public key of this user, and we are going to verify if that signature is valid or not. So we get the original message, the signature file, and the public key, not more the private key, because the private key, just the user that make the signature has that. So it will now, in this validate signature method, looks how it works. Validate signature, we have so the signature generated by the sync method, we have the original message, and we have the public key. So again, the same process as before. The only difference is the last instruction that here we call the verify method instead of the sign method. So in this case, we take the implementation of the DSA, we input the public key, not the private key in this example. We make the as parameter the message we are going to validate, and now we verify if the signature is valid or not. It returns a boolean. Okay, true if it's valid, false if it's not valid. So here we can play with that. Here we can validate it in the original state. So the original message with the signature we have generated, probably it will return as a valid message. And then we can play. If I use a signature for another message, it probably will return false because this message was not signed before. The signature is done by the first message, not for this new message. Other events, other situation here, we inform an invalid key to the method, so it also will not work. Here is this case, okay? And the same, everything, our examples here will simulate one example of invalid parameters that will not allow the signature to return true as valid, because for the signature returns valid, we have to inform the proper private key, sorry, the proper public key that is related to the user that has signed that, the message it has signed, the original message you have to still have access to that, and then the signature itself. So let's execute this code, running that. So here we can take a look in the output. So the first example, it's properly signed because you have here the original message that's here, the signature that was generated by this first instruction, and the public key related to the private key that was utilized when performing the signature. So just this example, we have a valid signature. All the other examples, I have changed the original message. Instead of using this message here, we are going to use this message here. No, it will return false. Right here, it returns false. Message has changed. A signature that does not match another invalid signature. What happens here in this example? In this example, we have another message. We perform another signature. So the signature is different than the first one. And we try to validate the first message with the first user public key, but using a different signature. Information does not match. And here, the valid signature for the first message, but using the public key of another user. So it also will return false. Okay, so here in this example, we have seen how to use this native Java class to use the GSA algorithm for verify signature, for sync messages, and for generating the public keys necessary to use these algorithms. And this code is available to be downloaded from GitHub. The link is below in video description. You can write down any comments if you have some doubt about this theme. And thank you for watching.